You know, my granddad used to say there are basically only two kinds of folks in the world, givers and takers. So decide which one you're going to be. And the longer I live, the more I'm convinced Grandpa was right. There are big-hearted, generous people. There are clutching, stingy people. We have also observed that the attitude with which a person approaches life doesn't seem to have much to do with how much one has. We have seen unselfish, generous, poor people. And we have seen tight-fisted, grasping, rich people. We've seen extravagantly liberal givers who had means. On the other hand, we've seen miserly, greedy, poor folks who hated everyone who had anything. It all depends on how we choose to spend the days allotted to us. My grandparents, Addie and Burl Hartwell, seemed to live simply for the joy of giving. Though they never had much of this world's goods, it was impossible to get out of the door when we went to visit them without them putting into our hands a head of cabbage, or a loaf of freshly baked bread, or a mess of corn from the garden for supper. I always wanted to grow up to be a giver like that. You know, today we're living in a world suffering from almost an epidemic of depression. We're taught to guard our own turf, be independent, and to not get too involved with the people next door. We're cautioned to be self-contained, self-protective, and ironically, self-indulgent. This song is not just a new nice ditty. It is a revolution. What could happen if the joy in giving everything away should take over the entire world? Jesus taught that it could. He said giving ourselves away could perfect us. He said giving away our food to the hungry, something to drink to the thirsty, our hospitality to the stranger, our clothing to the destitute, our care to the sick would make us heirs of God's entire kingdom. And physical food, water, housing, clothing, and care are just the tip of the iceberg. What if we were to truly offer food for the soul, water for the spirit, shelter of a place to belong, and covering for the raw and exposed heart? The best antidepressant to be found is this prescription from the old timers and from the master of life. If you want more happy than your heart can hold, if you want to stand taller if the truth were told, take whatever you have and give it away. If you want less lonely and a lot more fun and deep satisfaction when the day is done, then throw your heart wide open and give it away.
Now he was working in his garden when I happened by. He waved me over with that look in his eye and started breaking off some ears of corn. He said, "Here, boy, today this corn is just right. Boil it up for your supper tonight." As I've learned, it's true what my pappy used to say. And nothing's quite as good until you give it away. If you want more happy than your heart will hold, if you want to stand taller if the truth were told, take whatever you have and give it away.
All right.
If you want less lonely and a lot more fun, satisfaction when the day is done, throw your heart wide open and give it away.
Yeah, there's been a lot of water go over the dam since the day in the garden with my Uncle Sam.
So I hope you'll hear these words I have to say.
Now here it is, right here. There are two kinds of folks. There's takers and givers.
There's gripers and complainers and big-hearted livers.
It depends on how we choose to spend our days. 'Cause we can afford up all we've got. Or give it all away.
If you want more happy than your heart will
on casting. Soon as